Life in internally displaced persons camps can hardly be pleasant, as access to food, water, and other basic necessities of life are readily not available, even in the face of several government interventions. The situation becomes more complicated when officials of government saddled with the responsibility of caring for the needs of victims are accused of exploitation. At this conference in Abuja, organizers are meeting with some survivors of sexual exploitations in IDP camps from Uganda and Nigeria's northeast to share knowledge about how to manage post-traumatic stress. Hamsatu Alamin has been working with women in IDP camps for over 5 years now. She relates sad tales of stigmatization and loneliness suffered by women living in IDP camps in the northeast.
In the camps where these women are, they were secluded, they were rejected even by their own families, they were stigmatized and then kept in one side of the camp. In fact, they never associate with other women in the camps. And then I discovered that all of them were living in frustration, anger, and deprivation. And greater percentage of these women that I came across have all babies. Some of them are pregnant, some of them have babies.
Perhaps even more disturbing is the accusation of sex for food, allegedly perpetrated by government officials and often swept under the carpet.
Those who have been sent out to protect this woman, who have been mandated to protect the women and girls in the IDP camps, are actually the perpetrators of sexual and gender-based violence, engaging these women in survival sex, where they have to ask for, where they give sex in demanding for food.
Aka dauke mu aka kawo an yi release namu an kawo mu IDP camp Bakasi. Gwamnati ya je zuba mu a gaskiya abinci ana ba mu. But ba a kula da mu. Muna ganin challenge da yawa. Security da suna gadi mu ba su bar mu ba. An bata mana future mu. An bata mana tarbiyyar mu da iyayen mu suka ba mu.
Adong Winnie is also a survivor of sexual violence in an IDP camp in Uganda. She shares her experience on how victims can manage post-traumatic stress.
What I can recommend to the girls in Nigeria, they should come in a group. You know, when you're in a group, you can share your challenges or your experiences, and like maybe there's someone to help you, maybe to push you, to advocate. You can speak as one voice. You have what? You have the strength.
Conflict-related sexual violence is a widespread problem that leads many victims to lives of isolation, shame, and stigma that could lead to more complications, reasons why the Nigerian government enacted the Violence Against Persons Prohibition Act of 2015 to punish offenders.